Everybody, it's Brandon Marshall and welcome back to the Acne Channel. I am one of your very own Banished Warriors and today I have a very special video for you guys. As you can see by the title, I am going to be kind of digging a little bit deeper into the science behind and what microneedling does. So the inspiration for this video today, I actually was scrolling on Facebook and I saw a Banished ad and somebody had commented and said, "Hey, I want to know the science behind this microneedling thing. Can you provide that to me?" They wanted to see a video of it. So I kind of wanted to dig a little bit deeper and kind of answer that question, how microneedling affects your skin. We'll just sit back, chill, talk about science. Microneedling has been around for a very long time. It's just kind of like morphed into different things and now like dermatologists are using it. It's used for acne scars, other skin problems. It's even used for like hair growth. It's also used for stretch marks, wrinkles. Like it's just used for so many things. Science has kind of found all these things that it can be used for. So it's just really interesting in how it's evolved. And I have the Banisher right here. This is the first Banisher. I will kind of get into the Banisher 2.0 as well, but this is what it looks like. And it does have a bunch of little baby tiny needles here. Usually once the needles start getting a little bit longer on these, that's when you kind of want to see like doctors using those. So these ones are the perfect size to be doing it by yourself, not harming your own skin. Because sometimes if they're too long, you can harm your skin, honestly. But if you're careful and you're using the right needle size, it's definitely easy to see progress at home by yourself, and it's so much cheaper. So like I said, class, this is a little bit of a science lesson. Not really, but I'm gonna be using some kind of technical terms within this next couple minutes. The very top layer of your skin is the epidermis, and then under that is the dermis. So your acne scars, any kind of like pivots or anything, sunken scars, also hyperpigmentation, is gonna be on the epidermis. Basically what happens is, the way I like to explain it is, the microneedles, once it is punctured on your skin, it's basically creating little, almost like wounds. You can call them baby tiny wounds. We'll call them baby tiny wounds in the epidermis. And this is going to kind of trigger your skin and your blood flow to be like, hey, there's a wound, let's fix it. So that is the point where the collagen is going to be induced and it's going to rush to those spots and start to heal it. So if you are making those little wounds, your body is just, that's just how your body reacts. It's going to go to that spot and start generating slash fixing itself. So over time, that can definitely fill in scars. Also, it really works really fast on my hyperpigmentation. A lot of times if I use it in like a week, I create like really good results with my hyperpigmentation. Like it's not an indented scar, which can take months, whatever years to essentially fully heal. But hyperpigmentation can be a lot quicker. But then it does create that new like collagen layer. So after you're doing this over time, it's just kind of like going and going and going and going until essentially your skin can look flawless. Another really cool thing about it is that the fact that you are puncturing your skin with these tiny little microneedles, it also lets your creams or any type of serum penetrate your skin deeper and get in there and just really work. Sometimes a lot of creams and stuff, if your pores are closed and you haven't microneedled, they might just sit on your skin. This allows them to kind of penetrate your skin, your epidermis a little deeper and really get in there. So that's why you definitely follow it up with the Banish oil that has all those awesome properties in it, like the vitamin C, has also aloe and everything in it. So it just really penetrates your skin and just helps that collagen in your skin just look super plump. So yes, like I said, once that top layer of skin is punctured, it's going to allow those creams and any chemicals to really get down past that layer quicker and absorb faster. And it is a little bit of common sense, but you definitely want to make sure that you're cleansing your Banisher because you don't want anything to spread on your skin if you have any acne or anything like that. You don't want anything lingering on there. So you definitely want to make sure that you're cleansing it. That's just the one thing that I always am like, this needs to be said. No matter what, you need to cleanse it. Use some rubbing alcohol, soak it, make sure it's nice and clean before you use it, even after you use it. Like you definitely want to double cleanse it. And then I said I also would throw in the Banisher 2.0 in here. I just kind of want to talk about, this is kind of a way that it has, microneedling has evolved. Banish came out with the Banisher 2.0, which is essentially like the pen stamp, just a bigger ratio on it. And another way, it just has the little needles and you can kind of press it down to pinpoint those areas. So just a really another awesome way that microneedling can work. This does have the gold needles on it, which also helps with collagen production. I feel like microneedling has definitely come a long way, seeing older models of them and just seeing kind of where it's been. Yeah, I know this was just a quick little video. I kind of want to give you guys some insight. Hopefully answer that girl's question on Facebook that I saw. You can use my code Brandon10 if you want to get some money off of your kit. The link will be down below to purchase, as well as my social media. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye, guys.